Incontinence can be difficult or embarrassing to talk about, but you might be surprised to know just how common it is. Most of us, regardless of age, gender, or ethnicity, have dealt with an unexpected leak or dribble. In fact, 50% of people age 65 and older have urinary incontinence. And pardon the pun, but holding in symptoms and suffering only makes it worse. Incontinence is considered a social disease because it can impact your ability to live your life, especially when it comes to being out in public. This can be devastating to your sense of independence, happiness, and overall well-being. Thankfully, incontinence is treatable, so the more upfront you are about symptoms, the more help and support you can get. First, let's go over what incontinence actually is. Urinary incontinence is the loss of bladder control. The bladder acts like a balloon that holds your urine. When you need to go, urine is released through a tube at the bottom of the bladder. This tube is called the urethra. When your bladder muscles suddenly tighten, or the muscles at the base of the urethra suddenly relax, we lose control of our bladder. This is what causes sudden leakage. There are three types of incontinence: urge incontinence, stress incontinence, and overflow incontinence. You could have a combination of two or all three. Urge incontinence is when the bladder muscles are too active, causing frequent need to urinate, even when the bladder isn't full. When it comes to stress incontinence, the valve-like muscles in your urethra become weakened. As a result, any physical movement or activity, such as coughing or sneezing, puts pressure on the bladder, resulting in leakage. Overflow incontinence is leakage that occurs when the bladder doesn't empty properly due to a weak bladder or blockage of the urethra. There are a number of causes of incontinence. Some causes are harder to control, such as age. As you get older, your pelvic and sphincter muscles start to weaken. This could be from nerve damage caused by diabetes, trauma, or other health conditions. Other causes include prostate issues, urinary infections, constipation, and some medications. Exercise and some physical therapy may be able to help. Although not usually the case, incontinence can be an early signal of other medical conditions. Incontinence is a common early warning sign of diabetes, an enlarged prostate, and heart failure. So if you are experiencing symptoms such as frequent trips to the bathroom, talk to your doctor. They understand the medical causes of incontinence and will ask the right questions to help diagnose and determine next steps. If you've already scheduled an appointment with your doctor, consider completing a voiding diary 2 or 3 days beforehand. A voiding diary can better help your doctor with your diagnosis. You'll record what you drank, how much you drank, and the amount you voided, either a dribble, a little, or a lot. It's also important to record leaks and whether it was during an activity or you had the urge to go. You may notice some things that you can try fixing on your own, such as cutting back on your morning coffee or switching from running to walking. Incontinence can occur anytime and any place, but there are some things you can do to help control it and prepare for issues when you go out and when at home. One way to help control incontinence is to reduce excess body weight. Another is to quit smoking. Smoking can make you cough, which can put extra pressure on the bladder. You can also try avoiding certain foods such as citrus fruits, chocolate, caffeine, vinegar, dairy products, and aspartame. These are all possible contributors. When planning to be out, limit your liquid intake, especially triggers such as alcohol and caffeine. Make sure you locate the nearest restroom and plan for potential accidents by bringing extra pads or undergarments with you. At home, get in the habit of trying to urinate every 3 to 4 hours, whether you have to or not. You should also make sure the path to your toilet is as clear as possible and wear clothing that is easily removable. Use incontinence pads or undergarments as backup. The odor of leaked urine can leave people feeling especially self-conscious. Drinking cranberry juice can help neutralize the pH, reducing the smell. But if your urine has a strong odor, an infection may be present, and you should call your doctor. Remember that at some point, Incontinence becomes more than just an inconvenience, so it's important that you talk to your doctor about your symptoms. The sooner you can get treatment, the sooner you can take back control of your life. We hope you found this information on incontinence helpful. Thank you for your time. For more videos in our Healthier Together series, please visit CignaHealthierTogether.com.